Good camera work.
Yeah. It's becoming viral too. 11 views.
Yeah.
So
we're gonna get 100 view. You watch.
Yeah, 50. It's but they tend to plateau. They hit a number and they stop.
What's the count on Eric's?
Eric's is 249 views.
Jeez.
On Eric's little video.
That's sweet.
All right.
Really great. Yeah. Everyone pick up that camera work. It's really great.
I've seen that name.
Show the pedestal.
Here's an alert video from Greg.
I'm trying to catch a fly.
Yeah.
Again.
And Jimmy the biker, look at him.
Tell us the problem you were encountering the other day. What are we dealing with?
On a pedestal that you could see the inside of, there was a lot of glue on the inside, and since the inside was going to be seen, it had to be as clean as the outside.
Got it. So a smaller pedestal, right?
Smaller pedestal, taking a lot of time to just clean off the big glue on the inside.
Wow, that's no fun. So the solution that I'm thinking of that we've done before is the glue up people, when you're gluing a smaller pedestal, be more diligent about the use of the glue. It's not going to be subject to huge amounts of stress. But more importantly, get that thing off of the table and scrape when it's just kind of gummy. That's the perfect time to clean it out. That stuff sits overnight, then it becomes real misery. And especially anything that's been lacquered on the inside too. So that's the biggest component I'd have to say, other than just don't do excessive glue action. Thanks.
Nice.
I guess we already did that video.
Yeah, sure did.
Next. So maybe along those lines, maybe whoever finished up at the glue table could take that on themselves to make sure those, any that are ambience or small or something, could take care of that.
Well, 9x9s, do we even put 9x9s on the pad? Don't they just shrink wrap them?
No, we do. It works. I think our main problem is ambience. So if you're the person who's been gluing up, you're the last person that was gluing things up that day. I don't know who else we should put in charge of making sure those get cleaned up. You know, an hour after they've been on the pad.
Sounds like. Sorry, go ahead, Brad.
Go ahead.
Sounds like the system is the one who's going to be in charge. So would you drive that, Chris? Since I already took away your other project.
Yeah, sure.
I love dutiful people.
Hey, Greg.
You're the best.
And the ambience, since the glue is white and the inside is white, can we just smear off on the corner?
If you can make it look respectable, it's just got to, just remember, this is a finished product. When you get the Mercedes and you lift the hood and you go, oh my God, it's a, you know, what? It's a muddy, is there a gerbil under there, whatever, you know, it's the idea is the thing looks pretty sweet. Okay. We don't want to go apey, you know, deep into the bowels of it, don't worry about it, but if they lift that lid off, they have to have a good impression. When they turn over a small tabletop pedestal, let's not look like a bunch of schmucks. Everything about us says we're not, and then it's like, well, except this. So let's not be that. You guys, you know, just treat your, think of, it's really simple, golden rule. I'm the customer. I got, you know, I got $100 into this thing, $150 into this custom-made box, and I look at it, huh. Not so, you know, you want to go, hey, sweet, they care about it. Don't go crazy, but you got to find that balance.
I always just imagine that Greg's going to receive the thing.
Right.
To make it.
Thank you.
on the other end.
Yeah. Greg.
Maybe
I'm the quality Grinch.
I didn't have to write the name on it. That's good. Thanks. Looked it up.
Carry on. 11 minutes.
So, gentlemen, this is something we do for internal use. We'll have these up, and that's how we all get kind of just no secrets.
Anybody who's not here has the opportunity to be here at the meeting by watching the video also.
Right. Yeah, it gets emailed, so if you miss a day, you watch it, you don't miss any problem videos.
And when you have something to say, Seth, you are listened to intentionally and systematically. That way, you feel recognized. That's critical.
Okay.
Culturally.
The one thing today, I want to talk about this quote. Greg wants to talk about this quote.
Yeah, I love this. I'm reading a book that was referred to me by Nick Cosell, who runs that, you know, the skyscraper cladding business. And he loves this book, and I just started to get my teeth into it. And I just, these little quotable quotes, if you're not busy reinventing your company, I guarantee you are falling behind Fujio Cho, the CEO of Toyota. So what we're doing here every day when we do 3S-ing and improvements is we're effectively reinventing the way we do our processes. And what I've found as I've dug further into the bowels of this book, and I've read, you know, 2 Second Lean 100 times, and I've read The Toyota Way, and I'm, you know, delving into old stuff, the message keeps coming through, which is that continuous improvement is really the cornerstone of it. So our lean improvements are continuous because we're doing it every day. So that's it. Nice thought. So every day, the one thing for the rest of the week, including today, is what Jeff.
Grab you or Brad and make sure that your improvement is either acceptable or if you don't have one, get one.
Okay. So who gets grabbed first whenever possible?
You.
Yeah. So when do you grab me? Kind of later in the day or when you see me first walk by?
When you're busiest.
You got it. Perfect answer. Always look for the busy person. They're the decision makers. So what I'm trying to do is, including Brad and including LJ, okay, I want these guys to come to me and say, hey, Greg, I'm thinking about doing this project. What do you think? I want to know, again, that you guys are driving this, not me. I'm tired of being the nag. We've come this far. We can turn it around, and then you guys will be thinking and engaged. So no, that is your job when you walk in the morning. It's not the 3S. It's the, oh, shit, I gotta better have something to talk to Greg about when I see him. That's what you're going to be happening. So I know we're bringing it to the next level. I can feel it. I can taste it.
If you don't have something, you ask for it.
You got it. And all you have to say is what if you don't know?
What can I do?
I don't know.
Hell, I don't know. That's it. So if you guys start with that, you get the conversation going.
The other thing I can add to that, too, is stay ahead of the game and, you know, ask about your next days the day before.
Yeah.
So that you can come in the morning, there's no chat about it. You just do it, and then you have the rest of the day to think about your next day's improvement.
Yeah.
And you're not scrambling.
The one thing I'd throw in there is, hey, Greg, it's the same thing as yesterday. Let me know. I got 20-some-odd people here. I'm going, we talk about that Friday. What was the decision? Yeah, you wouldn't do that for a couple days. But there was some input I would like to have given you and you on your projects this morning. I would like to have done it in the form of questions, like a Zen master. But, you know, 30%, 10%, I don't know where I am. But the idea is we could talk about these problem-solving things together as you go through them. So just check in with me regardless of whether you're already working on a project. Say, hey, yeah, I'm still doing this. Got it. Thanks. Because we stretch some of these projects out here for a day or two. We were talking about that. Right. It could be a 10-minute fix, a 5-minute fix, right? Or it could be a project.
Okay. So today's thing is that. Pull Greg aside. Can't find Greg, find me and Brad.
You got it.
Any department in particular need of assistance today?
I'm leaving after this. So okay. There'll be one less person over there with the easels. I taught him how to do the router. And so
you need to be watched.
Yeah,
for a while, training more, right?
And so then you can get someone on the feet drilling.
Okay. Got it.
Just here.
So feet, drill, shape. So you got those two things. Yeah.
What about you?
Just wanted to make an announcement. Well, the air's down on that side. After the break every day, it's going to get blown out. So please don't turn the dust collection on with my head in there.
So that's not. Tell me what solution that is.
That's C.
I'm going to C-.
C-.
Yeah.
What happened?
Back up the pressure.
You don't understand how tempted I've been all last
week to push
that blood.
Right. Sorry,
Sean. It's running today. You won't need to go in there. It's at 80.
Right. So let's not over process that. So check with Bergy, myself. We'll come up with a system. You let me know what your system is.
I thought we were doing it daily though. It was working again.
All you gotta do is get that gauge. The gauge.
We'll come back and sideline that one. Sidebar it.
That's it, guys.
Waste everyone's time. Okay.
Thanks.
We'll do it.